Hey man, I just can't find a comfortable headset. I mean, I've tried everything. Literally everything.
Sheesh, my brother. I got you.
The HyperX Cloud 2 Wireless. Legendary comfort goes wireless.
That is comfortable.
Thank you. Blessed are those who wait. And if you stuck around for the fourth match of the night, you are about to find out why that is. We have a good one waiting for you. The Johnson and Wales Wildcats are coming hot off a sweep last week against Hood College and are looking to make it a bit of a streak, going 2-0 over the last 2 weeks. But in their way are the Randolph-Macon Yellow Jackets, who fell last week but look to straighten out their wings this week. Yellow Jackets going up against the Wildcats. Let's get cooking. My name is Ethan Dolan, probably better known as Nelhan on Twitch here, joined by Grant. Oh my gosh, what a guy. Just take a look at that man. Oh my goodness.
Oh, I appreciate it, Ethan. Well, hang on. Well, my microphone's down here. It is now returned to its rightful place, just like we have here in the booth, Ethan. Yes, that was an unplanned joke that I hope you folks at home have enjoyed. But Ethan, we're back at it again for the second on NECC. Let's go.
They can't keep us apart, baby. These two teams, Grant, heading this week, both knotted up at one apiece. Two teams looking to get that second W in the column there for their record. It's going to be a good one as we head into this D3 match. I am very excited. We've had a whole host of great matches today. We've got more good matches coming up. I'm just ready to get in the game here, Grant. Woo!
Me too. I cannot wait, because this is one of our lower tiers that we've got here, one of our lower divisions. And you know, I am a sucker for this lower level gameplay, because honestly, I would rather cast it than RLCS. Trust me, I've done both. I'm dead serious. Honest to God, I love this gameplay so much more. And we're already right into it. 3 seconds off the clock, and it looks like the push is so far strong for RMC. And coming around the corner is Treacy, over the top of one, but not over Jack Blocks. He says, not today. He'll send it away into the corner for Eternal, who's going to miss this one now off the back wall. Shot comes in, but wide again, back to its same position. But man, the offenses are coming out strong here. Both of these teams trading possessions as we get going, Ethan. What are you noticing so far?
As you said, some great offense right off the bat. Randolph-Macon and Jaewoo going at it off the bat. I really like the offensive intensity, Grant, and to me, this really speaks volumes to that the team that is able to step up and create some stops on defense will be the team to walk away. It looks like there's going to be no shortage of scoring opportunities. Jack Fox gets a solid look right there. Spitting Koala coming up. Good 50 for Randolph-Macon, and they may be able to find something out of this, Grant. Whoever can step up, play an ounce of defense, make it to go there, as we do see a turtle coming through with the clean save. Good angle. Trissy's be right there for another save. Randolph-Macon stepping up in a big way right here on the defensive end.
Yeah, you're absolutely right. The defense is back and forth as well. It's a pretty evenly matched, series, a match, whatever you want to call it. Both of these teams are pretty solid when it comes to both sides of the game. And here comes Chef Alo, setting this one up. Now it's Jack Clocks putting one down. They're not going to find the net just yet. Dreesy out to the midfield for Purims to take to the corner. Jack Clocks will wait to try to field the return. They don't. The rebound is to Treacy one more time, but their option was taken out. Now it's Spiffy Koala to the midfield, and the sidewall runs into Treacy along the way, but Eternal is able to clear this one out. Jack Blocks looks to push in, but they'll overshoot their target. Actually, no, they've swooped underneath. I didn't even see them. They came out of nowhere, and maybe this goal could have happened, but instead, it's going to remain in the backfield, and we're back to trading blows.
Absolutely. My eyes are on Spivy Koala, the grad student, culinary major, looking to cook something up this game, bringing some experience to the table age-wise. Always think that's a good thing to ground a team here as Randolph-Macon looking for something on offense. Purims, big demo right there, going to get the numbers advantage. Trissy is me trying to find something. Randolph-Macon, they can't quite make it happen. Unfortunately, on this end for offense, Eternal trying to keep the possession alive, as well as they're doing, Grant, keeping the ball on the opposite half, as well as they're doing in the middle of the field. They just can't quite convert these opportunities. And here's Jack Fox on the other end, setting up a shot. Spiffy Koala, once again, the grad student, going high right there. Chef Alo can't quite get it. They've got to scramble to get back on defense here. Here comes Randolph-Macon, and they can't convert yet another solid-looking opportunity.
Yeah, they're just, everybody's struggling, but also it's the defense as well. You've always got one person who's really solid when it comes to playing that save game, pulling out a savior medal when they can. Obviously, there aren't any yet, but I'm sure there are some on the horizon as Eternal sends this one back into a back pass. It's a great stop from Spiffy Koala. They have a shot, but the defense isn't there this time. It's Spiffy who finally finds the breakthrough.
Spiffy Koala, I called it at the beginning, the one to keep your eyes on. The grad student, as I said, studying culinary, cooked up a tasty little goal right there, Grant. And that's just the first course here as we're here early on in game number one, minute 30 on the clock. What does Randolph-Macon have to do to get back into this game? Their offense looks good. They just can't quite convert when it counts.
It all comes down to placement, really. When you're talking Rocket League, you have to place it where the defense just can't get to it or where they won't expect it. And just like that, that's what they do. Treacy puts it on the far right post here.
Absolutely beautiful. Chat is telling me that I'm wrong. I may have read the spreadsheet wrong, that Spiffy Koala is a freshman. RIP the note sheet. Forget everything I've ever said except for the fact that that goal will knot us up at one apiece with a minute 20 on the clock. Very solid goal right there, Grant. I asked you what we can do to get right back into it, and we saw right there another opportunity, but this time they actually do convert it, putting the ball where no defender could possibly hope to touch it. Solid shot in the bottom right half.
Yeah, it's just great teamwork as well, because we actually saw, oh my goodness, Purims get involved with the play as well. They got no, I think they may have gotten an assist credit. I hope they did, because, I mean, they helped line that shot up to go into that unpredictable space behind the defender that allowed them to score that equalizer. But now we're down to the 42nd mark with Eternal swinging around the right side and now shoveling it out to the midfield. It's Treacy. He's going to take it back up to the air, and they'll actually wait for it to come back down. Play the control game. This is what I like to see, especially from this lower level. If you can outsmart your opponent, if you can out-mechanic them even, if you can do something that is just more special, you're obviously going to have a way better chance at scoring. So 19 seconds, we'll see what the game has to say about it.
Absolutely, 15 on the clock, still not at one apiece. Looks like we're going to be headed to overtime here. 10 to go. Eternal trying to do something with the little time left. Can't quite find the follow-through on that shot. On the other end, Perm's probably just going to let someone bounce out. No, they do get one more touch. Eternal up. It skips before he can get in the goal. Great look from Randolph-Macon. But we've got overtime here in what is just game number one. Both will miss that aerial 50. And here is Chef Palo, the actual grad student studying culinary. Now, chef with the name, I should have figured, Grant. Treacy trying to end this overtime. Can't quite find an angle there. Big demo 2v3 for the time being. Purim's trying to find some sort of offense here, but the rest of the team isn't there. And the defense swarming as Jack Fox is able to try and clear this one. The angle. Oh, Treacy.
Oh my goodness, there are a lot of close attempts, just second by second, shot by shot. Here's another one blocked away by Chef Alo. And to the left side, like we mentioned before, the actual culinary major, it appears. They're trying to cook something up here, and they might have it back. The Jack blocks. They find it off the bottom, and it goes up to the crossbar. Again, it's all coming down to shot accuracy. We're now a minute into overtime, and they're still swirling, circling the net, lurking for their prey and their opportunity to strike. But they'll have to live for that one to see another day as they suffer again on defense.
They're going to be kicking themselves. The Wildcats will if they don't win this. Open goal opportunity. Treacy leading the charge. The defense can't find it. Oh, Chef Alo cleaning up the kitchen. And a mega win. Ooh. Oh, Jack Blocks can't quite convert. But they're going to stay on offense. Alo trotting down the corner. Solid bump there. Eternal right there to clean up the dirty laundry. A good piece of defense. Jack Blocks taking opportunity. Grant, this could be a solid shot. But Purim's right there with the defense. They may be able to turn this into a little bit of offense on the other end.
Oh, especially if they can capitalize here. They'll take to the skies, looks for the double, but Jack, the solid aerial to get up there quick enough and send this one away. But Treacy is already making the push on. Koala was just barely there to stop that one out. We've reached the 2 minute mark of overtime as Chef Alo carries this one out. Jack blocks to the back wall, bounces up off the lip. Nobody gonna go for this one. Chef will try, but they'll send it backwards. Not the best touch for them, but They're going to suffer yet again under the pressure of the opposition's offense. Eternal lobs one up to the back wall, looking for the double follow-up. They don't get there, but Tracy sent a shot. Our screen's blocked by the smoke. The physical playstyle trying to open things up further. Maybe some time here for Tracy. Everybody misses. Now it's back the other way. Eternal puts it to the corner, and Chef Alo moves around, but it's right in front of that one more time. It's dangerous still. Jack can't find the angle, and we're out of the town here. Out of the park it goes. Eternal, though, with the cut, can they finish it? They can't. It's off the post and out. I can't even believe how close we get from goal to goal, opportunity and opportunity, Ethan.
Oh, this one's looking good coming in, but yeah, another opportunity blown. A few open goals, a few missed shots, 3-minute overtime. What is the longest game in NECC history? This is what I need to know, because it feels like we might be approaching in on Treacy. Can't find it there. There's Ayla once again. Another save for them. I believe that's their second in overtime alone. Chef Ayla. Yeah.
We are getting word that the longest game was a 14-minute game. I can't even believe that. First of all, props to our broadcaster for just being able to pull that statistic out of thin air, much like this shot could have been pulled out. But Perms will be blocked and shut down by Spiffy Koala. Eternal, though, a big overarching shot. Look for the carry, but a great block. Jack blocks coming in clutch one more time. Chef Alo over the top. One more defender to beat. They'll send it just to the wayside. Eternal picks up the boost. This will work to their advantage very well, allowing the offensive pressure to die down just a little bit as we approach 4 minutes in overtime. We've crossed the mark. This is a back pass to Treacy. I'm not sure they were ready for it. Zero boost in the tank. The defense of Johnson and Wales is suffering just a little bit here. And I've also noticed the ping of RMC is suffering just a little bit, I would say.
Oh man, this is a clown fiesta. Grab your party hat on the way in. 4:20 on the clock here in overtime. Purim's getting back on defense. Should be able to clear this one out of the corner. Alo could get them out. Oh, Randolph-Macon, this could be it. 3-on-1 opportunity, and Spivy Koala just takes it out. The freshman putting in some work, and they may have a chance, but there's the defense once again, Grant. Both teams just getting oh so close as we move in to our 5th minute of overtime. We are looking at 2 full games here in game number one. Spivy Koala trying to find the ball there. Can't get it to go. Perims, 4:54 on the clock. Chef Alo getting back on defense. There's Koala with the clear, but good job by Eternal keeping the possession alive. Alo rotating out of the goal, and there are two players. Oh my gosh, the double in the corner. Spivy Koala maybe will take advantage of this one. Can they find the numbers on the back end? Oh, it's open, but no one's there to follow up. Grant, they may have a shot here. The double Eternal! 5 minutes and 16 seconds of overtime were needed to decide game number one. But when the dust settled, it would be the Yellow Jackets flying away with the win. Me, oh my. We are pissing just 1/5 of the way in here, Grant.
I can't even believe it. 1/5. That's okay. Woo. Goodness gracious. What a first game to open up our night, Ethan. This is incredible. The display of skill, the display of maturity, to be able to keep going back and forth for that long, just outstanding from both of these teams. But I will note one thing. You notice the moment we get into overtime, that third man roll, that's what I'm looking at, because you'll see the first two players push forward, but the third is like, I don't want to get involved with that. That's way too sketchy. That's out of my comfort zone. Maybe next week. I don't want to right now. But that's the thing. It's that passive play style, that kind of just, I'm going to chill in my zone. You know, just, I'm okay here. You know, I can sit in my chair and just watch the ball. I don't want to hit it or anything. That's the dangerous mentality that we saw, and I'm surprised no one got punished for it sooner. But in the end, it is RMC coming out with a victory, punishing that double commit that we were talking about.
Absolutely. Randolph-Macon making the most of the late moments there in overtime. We are headed into game number two here, Grant. If you're in the call for either team, what are you saying here moving forward? I guess particularly if you were on the losing side, if you're talking to the Wildcats right now, what are your words of inspiration after a heartbreaker like that? You know, playing 2 full game times and not walking away with the win.
Well, I think it's, I mean, what I just talked about with the third man role and all that stuff, keeping your rotation solid, but also, you know, letting them know that, hey, you played a really close game, nothing to be ashamed of. We still got this. We know we're close. We know we're pretty evenly matched. It's just going to be who can get that extra edge to send you over the top, and that's just what we need to see here. So Eternal is going to start us off here in the corner. We'll see if they are able to formulate anything like that and get that extra edge over their opponent. That consistency, maybe this placement, the flick up high from Treacy. Now to the back wall, double commit they need to take advantage of. Eternal tried, but Koala stopped. And we're back to more offense from RMC.
More offense indeed. Big save there by Eternal. Try to turn it into something. Can't quite track down the ball there. Third effort here. All three members committing to offense for the Yellow Jackets. Can they keep the possession alive? Perms trying to play it off the wall. Can't get it to go, but there's Eternal with the backup. Wow, beautiful shot from Eternal on the right block right there. Just pounding it home to get this game started.
Yeah, a great shot to the back wall, an even better follow-up to notice that the defense isn't even there, and they're like, hey, I've got an opening. Let's just take advantage of that. That's a great recognition of making that play. Great field awareness from, RMC, so good for them. We'll see what goes on now as Treacy takes to the skies for a change. Now putting it off the back wall. Spiffy Koala out the jack blocks. Far shot downfield per... Perims. I'm still struggling with that name for some reason. I apologize, but I'll tell you who's not going to apologize is RMC if they can keep a lead like this, but they're going to need to get out of their defensive half if they want to start instating themselves and building upon such dominance, but they are playing really passive right now, waiting for those 100% opportunities. They're not taking many risks. I take it back. Treacy with a double tap.
You take it all back, Treacy, with a wonderful double tap right there, Grant. The recognition in the open field is big for me, especially at this level. Understanding that there's a lapse in judgment, the defense isn't paying attention, they're not swarming like they should, there's a lack of rotations, Grant, and just seeing that opportunity, being able to seize the moment, having the skills to back up the opportunity, really able to convert it and bring it home. 2-0 lead for the Yellow Jackets right here, right now, and they are sitting pretty as they did win that overtime thriller in game number one as well.
Yeah, and I'm starting to notice a little bit of the rotations for Johnson and Wales be a little bit off. There's not too much communication going on when it comes to who's supposed to take out of the defensive half. They get some good things going, but that initial setup kind of sets them up for a bit of failure in the end of it. When they're trying to get out, everybody's kind of mixed up and not sure what to do. They need to be a bit more clear and concise with things like that. And here's a shot from Treacy. Jackbox jumped there. That was their ball, but Koala didn't have the trust. We got to get some of that going if we're going to see these rotations speed up and get to par.
Yes, Vivi Koala, another solid save there on the back end. Grant, they have to do something to find some offense here in this one, trailing 2 goals. 2 minutes and some change to go. Spiffy trying to play it off. Here's Eternal coming through, a solid piece of defense right there. Spiffy going to give it right back to Eternal. However, can Eternal find a play in the corner? Good piece of play. Wow, Eternal breaking ankles out here. Jaewoo absolutely looking lost. Somebody get the Wildcats a map.
Oh, I'll tell you what, they weren't 100% lost. They knew what they were doing, but you could see in the replay, Koala is the last person to make that diving save across the net, but they got tripped up by the post. It's a common thing that happens to us sometimes. They were all positioned really well. There was a moment where they may have been a little bit too close together, but they straightened themselves up and got ready for it. It's just those little things, those little stupid posts that get in the way so often. I tell you what. It's frustrating, but hopefully they don't let it go to affect them too hard here. They're only down by 3, which, is a tall order, but not when you're as evenly matched as this. Not when you know you've got a chance against the team you're playing. Nah, you got to keep that mentality fresh, that mental desk space clear as day if you're going to keep going in game number 2.
They've got to return to that passion they had in game number 1, Grant. They were looking so evenly matched. A little bit lethargic here on the rotations. As we said, Eternal going up has a solid opportunity. There is Jack Flox right there. Solid save. Keeps this game at a stretch and less of a miracle. But here's the follow-up. Perm's not able to get it to go. Jacklock's going to have to play some more solid defense here if they want to clear it, and they are able to do just that. Now, what can they do to find themselves goal? Jacklock's not getting the contact they would like right there. Double commit, but it's not really going to matter from RMC. Perm's able to clean it up on the other end. Solid play from Jacklock's, but it's not going to matter. Perm's right there to clean up a fourth goal for Randolph-Macon.
I'll tell you what, this play stems all the way back from that first offensive push of Johnson and Wales. The third man role I've been talking about all night so far is becoming a big question mark for both of these teams, but more so for JWU. You see the third man ready to make the stop. They're lined up in midfield, but when the time comes, they don't quite make it there. They don't even try for it, and it's really drawing me some concern for this team and why they're down at four goals. They really need to straighten up that third man role, take these risks that they've been so reluctant to pull off in this series. They got to get in the faces of RMC if they want any chance at taking another game.
Absolutely, Grant. They want to do just that. These two Eastern Conference opponents both looking, as we said, to improve to 2-1 right now. I will tell you what, Randolph-Macon looking much better than they showed last week in a 1-3 loss against Hood College. Put another shot on goal. That one's not going to find its target. They're trying to find a follow up. It's not going to matter. 5 seconds on the clock. This one is going to go down as a big yellow jacket win. Leading two games to none, trying to finish off a clean sweep here, Grant.
It could happen too, and that's the scary thought. RMC has been on top of it, regardless of whatever their ping's doing. They're like all identical, but two have the caution sign. I don't know what's going on there, but I mean, they're throwing that caution to the wind. I can tell you that for sure. They are taking the risks that we need to see, something that JWU has not been so really wanting to take. That they don't want to go for anything too risky. And I mean, we've seen some flashes of greatness in game number one, but this time everybody was just more focused on their rotations and making sure they had that down rather than actively participating in the game itself, which is really ironic because the goal of the game is to, you have to participate. Now, I know that might sound like I'm coming down on that. I'm not, because like I said, these teams are very even in terms of everything that they're doing. Their rotations are solid. Their shot placement is pretty even across the board for all six players in the lobby. It's just RMC are taking the risks. They're hitting the ball. They're going for it. They're not really afraid. And you can make them panic on defense, though. So if you are Johnson and Wales, you need to get those offensive pushes and you need to keep them going. You need that third man to make up for any mistakes that go wrong in persons one and two. If they can't make a touch, it is up to you to stop that. And there was a big clear. It's like coming along and you just got to smack it away. You got to keep the offense going, keep the pressure going, because eventually it has to go somewhere. It has to burst.
Absolutely, Grant. This third man is going to be so important here in game number three. And pressure does indeed burst pipes. We'll see which team will have the leaky waterworks after this one. Spiffy Koala starting off with a big save, but can't quite find the second one. Doesn't matter. Shot is going to be a little bit tall. Spiffy and the rest of the gang trying to find some defense here. Chef Halo may have actually found a little bit of an offense. Bad rotation there from the Yellow Jackets, but nothing's going to come of it. Spiffy leading the charge, trying to find something here, but there's Treacy keeping it alive. Chef Halo can't get up in time. Treacy, it looked like it may have been going in if there wasn't another touch from a teammate, but nonetheless, nothing going to come of it. About a minute elapsed, and neither team on the board just yet.
Yeah, and I like I said, I was talking about the rotations, and that's basically the biggest point that I've been making, and everybody's doing well. JWU, they're doing well, but I think I've just pinpointed the secret sauce that needs to be put into this recipe. Woo! We talk about Chef Alo, speak of the devil, scoring this one. It's all about the transition here. Chef Alo, doing what I was just about to touch. When you have a transition, you have to take charge. You have to lead your team to that next offensive push. This one just happens to hit the back of the net, and they go up 1-0 first.
Sometimes you need the older members of the team to do it, and oh my goodness, Jackbox put in another absolutely beautiful shot right on goal. They can't quite convert, but it did look good, and this is a different team already, it feels like, as they are threatening on offense once again. Johnson Wales University White pouring in some attempts. Oh, Jackbox soaring in from off frame. Can't quite get that one to go either. Grit, what has changed for this team right here? They look like a completely different beast.
They're taking the risks, I tell you, and Koala takes the risk on this 50 to send another arcing shot to the other side. The comeback might be in store for Johnson and Wales.
Johnson and Wales, they said we are not done just yet. 3:15 yet to play. They already hold a 2-0 lead. They just got to hold on to this one, and we will be headed to a game number 4 after dropping the first two. They've shown some resilience, some fight. As you're saying, Grant, they are showing that they can be risk takers too. Oh. A turtle shut down Koala. Some great demons right there. Jackbox, I think, is AFK. They're playing a man down despite having a 2-point lead right now. A turtle's going to score off that. Just unfortunate circumstance for them.
Yeah, it seems like they're having some controller duplication glitch going on in the chat. You see Jackbox in parentheses 2 joining and leaving. So unfortunately, we cannot pause the game. We don't have admin privileges. We're going to have to play this out. Actually, we're going to see a bit of sportsmanship, I hope, here. Yes, we are. RMC being very courteous. This is just awesome to see. This is the stuff that gives me faith in the Rocket League community once again. This kind of sportsmanship is it's so amazing. I have no other word for it, Ethan.
Absolutely, and Grant, though RMC are the Yellow Jackets, I've never seen a Yellow Jacket show mercy like this. Those little wasps, those hornets, whatever they are, they're beaks, technically, absolutely ruthless, by the way. Just the worst.
Yeah, I've never been stung, and I don't plan on it. But hey, you know what really makes this a great show of sportsmanship is the fact that they're still down a goal. And they may not even get a chance to score one because they're doing this act of kindness for Jackbox with their controller. We're just going to have to play out the rest of it, but it's just going to keep going. This is their choice to let this go. They don't know that we're not restarting. They're asking a bunch of questions. Hopefully,
they can restart. Yeah, I think it is what it is. I will admit I'm not the most versed on the NECC rulebook.
Same. I'm not even going to make a call.
We do have producer in our ears asking what happened. We do have a controller malfunction.
But the other team is letting this happen. They're letting the issue resolve. They're not playing the game. They're under the impression that we're restarting. They want to know what we're doing.
Sure, there's not much precedent.
They're just gonna try to tie it up.
The goal just blows it.
They said tie. Okay, so here's what's going on. It looks like we're just gonna tie the game, send it to overtime, and then they're gonna play it out. I like this compromise. This is good thinking. I like where this is going. Let's see if they can pull it off, though.
There are
hopefully
some
nobody.
Big brains on display here at the NECC tonight. Everyone, take
wait. Koala's not gonna let it happen. Toxic.
We may have some bad blood here, Grant. There may be a rivalry in the East.
There
we go. I don't think it's Perm's gonna score that goal right there. 46 seconds on the clock. If you're just joining us in chat, one of the players' controllers broke for Johnson Wales University, and they've now left the game entirely. Looks like we've got a 2v3 happening.
Yeah, I'm just gonna fill in the players on what's going on, Ethan. So you give these players, or you give the audience at home a little bit of an Ethan Dahlin podcast.
Oh, Ethan Dahlin podcast. I will say, well, there isn't much precedent for this. If you've been sticking around with the NECC for a while, Becker versus Champlain, and my producer Caleb Blue may remember this one, was a League of Legends best of 3 match that did indeed go to 5 games over complications. The board got brought in to make a decision. A tree fell on a player's house. There was a 4v5 played. There was multiple cheating violations that had multiple game pauses. So this is maybe not the most wild thing that's happened, but it has been an interesting series so far. Excited to see it continue, but it might be a 2v3 from this point on. Grant informing everyone in chat they don't have to settle OT. One Jack reconnects, and it looks like that's probably what they will do. Chef Alo going to touch the ball. Bold move right here. We're going to see what happens, but I believe that's the right play. Just allow the reconnect, play the overtime, get it going. Sudden death. This is interesting.
Yeah.
I hope everyone in chat is enjoying this odd turn of events. If you're just joining us, this is Randolph-Macon College. The Yellow Jackets going up against the Johnson & Wales University Wildcats.
Yeah, this is really interesting. But I told the players that they can do whatever they want to. They probably, my assumption of the rule book, I'm not the most familiar with it. That's not my job. My job is to give out hypotheticals about the match going on ahead of us. But my guess would be they don't have to, we're not going to restart the game. They don't have to let this 3v2 be on pause. They don't have to tie the game and let it go to overtime like it has so far. If I had to guess, they could just play the 3v2 if they wanted to, but I said I recommend for sportsmanship's sake, which is really epic what we're seeing here, that they let Jack reconnect their controller, and once get back in, they can kind of go over a bit of a restart, maybe do a kickoff from the corners or 50 it in the middle, do whatever they want to, and then play the match out from there, play the rest of the overtime. That's what I would recommend. If just for sportsmanship's sake.
Chef Alo trying to center this ball. Don't worry, we've got our best senior on it here. Both players trying.
Just pinch it in the middle, guys. Look at this.
Oh, man.
Resetting the kickoff.
Oh, man. I hope you grabbed your party out of the way. And once again, this one has been a clown fiesta from minute one to right now. We started off with a 5-minute overtime, then a bit of a stomp in game number two, and we're all knotted up here. Our second overtime of the series. This one, I would say, marginally more interesting than the last one.
Yeah, this is very interesting. We could see a longer overtime. You know what? See, they could go for the record here if they wanted to. Hopefully. All right, so here's what's going down.
Stall for 12 more minutes. Come on.
We gotta go. Yeah, we'll start a podcast now. So what's going to happen now, what we've all agreed on, us as casters, them as players, and probably abiding by the rule book. I'm just using my best judgment here. What's going to happen is once Jack reconnects, they have recentered the ball here for kickoff, the best that they could. But once Jack reconnects, we're just going to put everybody in corners, and they're just going to go for the kickoff like a normal match, sudden death, take it in overtime. But yeah, we're just going to stall for, my goodness, Eternal. That was impressive right there, driving on two wheels. But we're just going to stall for an extra 11 minutes, I suppose, Ethan.
I need the record. If I don't get the record, what has this all been for? Our second long overtime of the night. You know, Grant, well, we've got the moment here just to sip. Give me your take on the aesthetic choices of all five players currently in game. I'm particularly drawn right now to the glasses on Spivy Koala.
Yeah.
Phenomenal decision, if you ask me.
Yeah, I mean, you can see the silver decal. I don't know if our broadcaster can get in on this. Oh, no, I've changed my camera somehow. I'm going to go back to that for a second here. But, no, you can see. I'm going to fly over here for a second. You can look, and you can see the silver. I'm not sure what season reward that is, but they've got silver wheels, silver decal, and the black shades. I love the all-silver aesthetic. Even the headlights on the Fennec line up with that. A really good choice of design. This passes in my book. Now, if it were me, maybe I'd throw on a bit flashier of wheels, maybe something white or something. But I'm going to stop this one right now because Jack Flux is back in the game. I'm going to start running this now, Ethan.
I say everyone starts in the goal. That seems like the best option. Oh, corners. We got corners. All right. Goal. I like goal. All three in the goal. This is going to be good. A dead heat to the ball. What are we looking at right here? Are we going to get a countdown? Oh, Jack
Flux. Is he there?
Let's. I say that we start at 4:35. Are we just set an arbitrary time?
I'll say. No. We'll say. All right. We're just gonna count this down.
And we're off. Oh. I think Jaehaelin took off a little bit early. Some dirty tricks coming through from Jaewoo. They're doing all they can to win this one. Spivvy Koala off the back end. Oh, can't quite find the double tap to send that one home.
Oh, Chef!
Position. Chef couldn't quite clean it up right there. Trissy trying this one out of their own half. Whoa. Ooh. Randolph-Macon, they need to step up and play some defense. They have to clear this ball and do it in a hurry if they want to walk home with the sweep.
Things getting real shaky right off the bat. I was a bit scared that there was going to be some cheeky, dirty plays to settle this one, but it looks like everybody's settling back into their own rotations and their own playstyle, despite the technical difficulties and the mentality shift and all this craziness that we just got to witness. For those just joining us, we are at a 5.5 minute overtime. Now, looks can be deceiving because actually what happened is Jack Blocks disconnected. Their controller just wasn't connecting all right and stuff, so we decided... Once we saw a great display of sportsmanship from RMC, and they just stopped. They stopped play. They could continue with the 3v2, but instead they tied the game. Everybody allowed the tie game to happen. We sent it into overtime, and we waited about 4 minutes for Jack Blocks to get their controller under control before we sent them into the goals. And like you just saw, we did the kickoff, we did everything, and now we are here. Six minutes of overtime have elapsed as a sick shot almost just went in for Johnson and Wales. A bit of dueling in the midfield. Things will end for RMC. Eternal scores this one, and RMC take it in three games.
A bit of fun for the whole family over the course of that series, but it will be a quick show of three-game sweep for the Randolph-Macon Yellow Jackets, who right their wrongs from just a week ago against Hood College. Grant, they will be improving to 2-1 on the season, while Johnson Wales, the Wildcats, looking like the Tame Cats this week, will fall to 1-2.
Yes, a quick show in a 3-0 is how we sum this one up. But honestly, it wasn't quick because we had 5 minute overtime in game one. We had game two go a little bit differently, one-sided. Then we had a 6 minute overtime in game number three. Controller issues, technical issues, but I say it every time it happens. What's a good esports broadcast without some good old technical difficulties, Ethan?
You need a little bit of scuff for it to truly be an esports broadcast, for being 100% honest. Grant, Randolph-Macon, looking forward, what are your expectations for this team after seeing this sweep here in the third division?
I mean, I'm not really sure because I spent so much of that time focused on Johnson and Wales, but obviously with those problems being a little bit present, RMC able to overcome those, that says some good things about them. I expect good things, especially from a 3-0, from something so evenly matched as it seemed. But Ethan, would you like to make a decision for who we should pull in on a bit of a interview?
I say we bring an Eternal, game-winning goal, phenomenal all series long, just looking like an absolute stud out there tonight.
All right, well, we'll go ahead and get them in here as soon as we can and ask them a couple questions. I've got maybe one or two. I'm sure you've got some. I mean, being that star to seal the deal in game number three, seal the 3-0 sweep, I'm sure we've got some interesting intel to pick from the brain of Eternal as we get them in here.
And if the data isn't failing me, as it did earlier on, Eternal, talk about picking the brain, is a criminology major.
Oh, okay. A little bit of play on words. I like that.
Grant. Criminology and psychology. We may be in trouble.
We might be. We may be. But I think we're having a bit of technical difficulties. And like I say every time, what's a good esports broadcast without them? You love them. I mean, at least I do. But I don't know what's going on here. It doesn't look like we can get them in. Not sure.
It does make... Oh,
ad. All right. We want to do ad read. All right. We got an ad read first. Well, I'll tell you what, our friends over at MetaPro Gaming are a full service esports management, developmental and consulting company. Meta provides esports coaching, college esports management, arena design, and equipment. Visit them at metaprogaming.gg to learn more. And Ethan, I see you're sitting in our next sponsor's product. Spawn products are forged for all day comfort for content creators, professional and casual players, and anyone looking to upgrade their setup. Then, what do you got to say about that product?
Man, I got to say, easily the best chair I have ever owned. I upgraded last season from folding chair to this absolute beast. Would buy, would recommend, would kiss that pillow again. 10 out of 10, Grant.
All right, good to hear. Our next sponsor is HyperX. You're all familiar with them. Their mission has been to develop gaming products for all types of gamers, high-speed memory, solid-state drives, headsets, etc. You get the point. They basically make it all. To the gaming community and beyond, their gear is a choice of plenty of celebrities and professional gamers. Get your hands on some of that stuff. Helix Esports offers world-class gaming and virtual reality experiences, state-of-the-art esports facilities throughout the United States. Helix Esports delivers a professional experience to everyone. Whether gamers choose to play, practice, socialize with friends, or compete at the highest level, they are there for the premier destination for gamers. Follow them today at Helix Esports USA. And finally, before we get onto this interview, ESTV, the first ever dedicated channel for esports and gaming personalities, the first channel devoted to 24/7 esports coverage, can be found on a number of OTT platforms, including the Roku channel, Amazon Fire TV, Samsung TV, Sing TV, and Vizio Free Watch. ESTV partners with the world's top gaming networks and production partners for the most robust esports content lineup on linear, online, and mobile. For more information, please visit www.estv.co. And without further ado, the moment you all have been waiting for, Eternal is in the chat. How are you doing, my guy?
I am great, man. How are you?
We are doing fantastic in the booth. Well, listen, you scored the game-winning goal there, but I want to pick your mind a bit there. I just want to give a big kudos to you guys, first of all, for that display of sportsmanship. That was just a really awesome thing that I just never get to see in the Rocket League community. You know, it gets kind of toxic once you get up into GC. So kudos to you guys. Seriously, what was kind of going through your mind? Like, you had a bit of a five-minute limbo to go off of. What were you guys thinking? Were you strategizing? What were you talking about?
We were pretty confused for a while. We had some people saying, oh, this game still counts. You know, we have to still try our hardest. We still got to, you know, win. But I told everyone, I was like, we're not going to win off of a, you know, 3v2. You know, that's just not fair. So whatever happens when he gets back, we'll find a way to work with it. We actually did start with 100 boost. I'm sure they did too. But that was just a little strategy that we had picked up. For a second there, I was a little worried because we had to get right back into rotations after all that, and that took us a minute. They definitely had some good plays that they could have pulled off on us right there at the end, but we weren't too worried. So,
well, you guys handled it well. I could give it major props to you guys. But Ethan, what do you got to ask Eternal here?
Yeah, I guess the first minor question out of the way, is it true? Psychology, criminology major?
Yes.
I need you have a diagnosis. Grant and I, there's something not right between the two of us.
I'm not sure. I just started my major classes.
All right. More research has to be done. This is a case study. Very longitudinal. We need some time to crack into these bad boys. My question is, in game number one, going to an overtime that long, how did you find the confidence to come out and just start absolutely smacking the game number two? You guys ran up the score in a hurry after such a close game. Where did that boost come from?
So, I mean, I'm pretty used to long overtimes like that, just from grinding out, you know, casual and ranked and all. And I just constantly tell myself over and over, I'm like, I'm not going to lose after this long of overtime. You know, I have to score right now. I have to score right now. And it just never happens. And, overtime keeps going on. So we kind of told ourselves that they were going to come out looking for blood second game. And we had to do the same thing.
Yeah.
No, Grant, go ahead.
I was going to say a great handling of, I mean, just awareness. First of all, I love that mentality. It's just like, keep on striking. And it was something that I was commenting a lot about the way that Johnson and Wales were playing. They didn't want to take the risk that you guys were putting on to them. So again, props to you guys. Kudos to you guys. All the words that exist within that synonymical category. Something like that. I was going to try to make like a really long word out of the word synonym. Just make one up. Didn't work. Tongue gets twisted. Other things get twisted. But that's all I've got for Eternal. Ethan, if you've got no more.
Eternal, what do you have to plug?
What?
do you have a plug? You got like an Etsy? Do you make anything cool? What do you got?
Look up Purims on YouTube, my boy.
All right, we got Purims on YouTube. Thank you so much for stopping by. Fantastic game. It's a joy to have you in the booth.
Thank you.
All right, Grant, and the same question essentially to you. What are your parting thoughts here as we're going to head into a quick break before some more Rocket League?
My parting thoughts are none, because we are probably a little bit too far behind on the broadcast schedule. So I say we just slam it into break and I'll pick it back up. Ethan, I know you've got to go off, but it was great casting with you. We'll do it again soon for sure.
For sure we will. So long, farewell, Alfeeder Zane, and goodbye. Everyone in Twitch chat, have a blessed night.
Hey man, I just can't find a comfortable headset. I mean, I've tried everything. Literally everything.
Jeez, my brother. I got you.
The HyperX Cloud 2 Wireless. Legendary comfort goes wireless.
That is comfortable.